Won't you be my neighbor? Won't You Be My Neighbor is directed by Morgan Neville, and this is a bit of a different film than I have reviewed on my channel so far. This is a documentary about Fred Rogers, or as many people know, Mr. Rogers, from Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood. This was a program that I grew up watching on PBS. This is a program that I'm sure many young children watched growing up that are now adults like myself, and this was a program that was on for several decades. And this documentary is all about taking a look at the person of Fred Rogers and his impact upon the generations of people, and ultimately what his philosophies were, what his mindset was, and what his ultimate goals were in life for his television series. This film has been getting a lot of positive buzz over the last several months because it has been showing in a lot of small independent theaters as well as at film festivals, and I've been hearing so many positive things about it that I really wanted to watch it, and it finally came to my local cinema, and I have to say this is one of the best films I've seen this year. It is a film that I think is very important for our time. It is taking a look at someone who was so unique, so different, and so genuine in the way he acted. And you can tell how big of an impact he had by just listening to all of the people they interview in this documentary. All of them really show this type of real-world affection for Fred Rogers and for really what he tried to do. And this film really delves into so many different aspects to Mr. Rogers, not just what was on the surface, not just the fact that he was part of this educational television program for children, but what he was really trying to attempt on a more philosophical level, how he was trying to really help generations of children grow up in a world that was getting increasingly more violent, more dangerous, and more manipulative. He was trying to be a positive force within the lives of children. In a lot of children's programming, things are dumbed down or they're not talked about because they're considered faux pas or children won't be able to comprehend or understand it. And Mr. Rogers completely dismissed that notion. He thinks if you were able to communicate with a child on their level and explain things to them on their level, that they would understand the way adults can understand. And he was also able to really come out and discuss a lot of very controversial things. He discussed things like divorce and death and depression and a lot of things like that. And this film also shows an interesting side of Fred Rogers, the vulnerability and the self-doubt that he had. He's always been this person who has been able to be this shining example of positivity, but this film shows him that he had a lot of self-doubt in what he was trying to attempt. And it's very interesting how the movie tries to use that in order to balance the film out. Unfortunately, I don't think the film is completely perfect. It is as near perfect as it could possibly be for me personally, but one of the more negative aspects I have with it is the film runs only 94 minutes long. That's an hour and 34 minutes, including credits. And there are so many things that are shown to us or told to us about Fred Rogers, about Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood, about the puppetry and the philosophies behind everything, that the film is unable to take the time, I believe, necessary to unpack a lot of things. There is so much to unpack with this movie, but that is something that doesn't hinder the film entirely for me in any way. This is a film that shows that there are so many things that we are dealing with in our world that have been consistent now for decades, and they're more prevalent now than ever before, especially a world that has such hatred and such toxicity in it, especially here on the internet, that is readily apparent every day. One of my favorite messages or philosophies from Mr. Rogers that is heavily prevalent throughout the film is the idea that we are all special. Not special in the fact that we have extraordinary abilities or the fact that we are going to do amazing things or we're destined for some greatness, but just the fact that we exist, we all have self-worth. That is an extremely important message that he was saying back in the late 1960s that is also really important now. So with all of that being said, I'm going to give this film a very high score of 4.75 out of 5 stars. This is a great documentary. I don't get to see a lot of documentaries in the cinema because they don't get the same wide distribution as feature films do, but I'm really glad I got to see this one. If you grew up with Mr. Rogers' Neighborhood, even if you didn't and you just want a movie that is a lot different than what you typically see at your local cinema, please give this a watch. So that has been my review of Won't You Be My Neighbor. If you like this video, please check out the other videos on my channel.